let us now have a look at other functions of design and at how we can efficiently work with them. We can use the design rooms command for the demonstration. So let's select these rooms and export them to design. The design dialog window opens. Let's log in and type the credentials, or if you have typed them while using other functions of the plugin, just click directly on the button Login. Now if you're logged in, you can see all your stored projects in the Projects tab. Here you can rename them or add a description. Let's go back to Offices and insert a diffuser from the catalog. For example, linear diffuser, Helle. Let's select this working point and insert the device to the room. Here we can position it. Notice that if we move it too close to the ceiling, or the wall in this case, it will give us a warning. In addition, if we change the size, a notice will appear, adjusting the working point to the closest valid point. In the second room, let's add a device through a product selector. After defining the search criteria, we can select one of the products. For example, cap F. Let's choose a working point, add it to the project and position it. Now let's say we want this exact same product in other office. We can make a copy and move it to that room. Let's position them automatically. So now we have set all the offices and we can import them back to Revit. We could choose the name of the system. Although all of these air terminals are mostly used as supply air devices, so the system was selected by default to supply air according to the most used setup. Let's wait for the conversion, and the products will be placed there automatically.